Hi, kids.
Hi.
Hi.
Thanks for coming out this morning. My name's Doug, and I'm a corn scientist. Today we're going to talk about a little bit how corn grows and what it's used for in the different parts. Sounds like fun?
Yes, yes, sir.
Why don't you tell me your names?
I'm David.
I'm Jackie.
I'm Elizabeth.
I'm William.
I'm Alexis.
Today we're going to talk about corn, how it grows, the different parts of it, and what it's used for. But let me ask you a question. Do any of you know what corn is used for?
Eating.
Eating. Anything else? Who eats corn?
Pigs, turkeys,
animals,
cows,
hens.
People and people, right? Don't you eat corn?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's right. Now we're in the middle of this big cornfield and all these great big plants. You know how they got here?
From seeds.
From seeds, that's right. And I have some seeds here. In this particular field, we have two different kinds of corn, and I'll give you some seeds. This is seed of field corn. Now, field corn is the kind of corn that animals eat. And it's growing here, and it doesn't have any tassels. It's like this corn right here, okay? The other kind of corn that we have in this field is sweet corn, which we see right here with these tassels on the top. And you'll see when I give you these seeds that they look very different. Okay, here's a seed of sweet corn. Now, can you tell me what the difference is? What the, in the, how they look?
One's all crumpled up.
And the other is straight.
It's smooth, that's right. One's all shriveled and wrinkled, and one's smooth. And the reason for that is the sweet corn has a lot of sugar in it. That's how it gets sweet. And when it dries, the sugar kind of contracts and it gets all wrinkled. But the field corn has a lot of starch in it, and it doesn't shrink so much when it dries, and so it doesn't get all crinkly. Now, corn has been around for a long, long time, and the Indians first used corn. And I have some ears of Indian corn here.
Cool.
Of a type that the Indians may have used. Now, they had many different colors and sizes, and this is just one example. But they used corn to make corn flour.
Look, there's purple.
From which they'd make different breads and tortillas out of. And they also used it in different ceremonies that they had. And, of course, they'd make tortillas and things like that. So this is an example of Indian corn. You can see it's not sweet corn. It's not shriveled and wrinkled like the sweet corn. It's harder like the field corn you have. You see that? Okay. Well, let's talk a little bit then about the parts of corn. And we'll talk a little bit about ears later on, too, okay? The way a corn plant grows is you plant the seed in the ground, of course, and today we use big tractors to do that. The Indians used sticks, and they'd put the corn in the ground, and they wouldn't plant big fields of corn. They'd plant smaller fields because they didn't have tractors and planters. So when we plant the corn and water it, it starts to grow, of course. And at first, it looks like a little grass plant. It starts growing bigger and bigger leaves. And also, this part starts growing here. What do we call that?
Stem.
The stem, or the stalk, we call it in corn. And as the stalk grows taller and taller and the leaves grow bigger and bigger, then it starts putting out, what do you think is under the ground here? We can't see them.
Roots.
Roots, that's right. The roots start getting bigger and longer and deeper. And the roots are very important in a corn plant, as they are in all plants, to take up vitamins for the corn. But also because the corn plant gets so big up on top here, the roots have to go very far in the soil. Why do you think?
So it can stay up instead of falling.
That's right, to hold it up, because sometimes we get big storms and a lot of wind, and if the corn didn't have good roots, it would blow it right over. So as this corn plant continues to grow, it gets taller and taller, and you know, how fast do you think a corn plant might grow?
An inch a day.
You think an inch a day. How, any other have an idea?
3 inches.
You know, it's been measured that some corn plants in just the right environment will grow as much as 5 inches a day.
Wow.
That's a lot, isn't it? Now, you've probably heard the expression, the corn's growing so fast you can hear it growing, and that you probably can. It's growing so fast. Okay, as the corn plant continues to grow, it reaches a certain height, and it starts to put out its last leaf, and this is the last leaf that it puts out, okay? And when you can look across a cornfield, and you can see, as a cornfield gets tall, it's very even for a long time. But then this last leaf comes out, and it starts to get kind of a ragged appearance on top. And you know that this part, which is called the tassel, is just about ready to come out. Now this tassel is a very important part of the corn plant. It's not the part we eat, but it's the part that the pollen comes from. And that's what all these bees we hear are interested in. They're interested in the corn pollen. So the tassel starts to come out, and the branches of the tassel expand. And about the same time, right here, we have a part growing. Now, what do you think this is? Right here, you have any idea?
The corn?
Right, that's the corn. That's going to become the ear, and that's the part that you'll eat. So as the tassel starts to show up on top of the plant, the ear starts to grow out of behind one of these leaves, okay? And inside, like I said, the tassel is a very important part because that's where the pollen is. That's what the bees are interested in. And here, where the ear grows, is a part of the corn plant called silk. Now, we don't find any there yet because it's a real young part, real young ear. But we'll probably find some here. Okay. Now that's called silk. Why don't y'all feel that? What's that feel like to you?
Hair.
Hair, that's right. It's called silk. But in Spanish, the word is pelo, which means hair. Now we're going to take apart one of these ears, immature ears that we've taken off a plant so you can see what's inside. Okay? Now each silk goes to where an individual kernel is going to develop. You see that? Let's get another one here. The Indians used to make dolls using the corn husks, and they'd tie them in knots, and they'd look like they had dresses, and they'd use the silk for the hair. And they...
It's neat.
Neat, huh? Now in about 30 days, the corn ears that we just looked at are going to look like this. And I'll give each one of you an ear of corn that's ready to eat.
Wow, look.
And each one, now the kernels have developed. Go ahead and tear it apart. You can take these the husks off, the outside leaves. And you can see there's kernels in there. Okay, as you tear it open, you'll see the silk. And if you looked really closely, you'd see that the silk goes right between the kernels of corn. And it goes right to the point where that little kernel started to form. Now, of course, when you eat the corn, you don't eat the silk. You try real hard to wash all that silk off. But sometimes when you eat corn on the cob, maybe you've gotten some silk that didn't get washed off completely. And what you're doing now, you're shucking the corn. It's a very important part of getting it ready to eat. You shuck it. That means you take the husks off. Good, huh? Okay, now I have a box of some things that use corn in them. Very interesting fact that there are over 3,500 products made using corn. Well, that's it. Isn't it amazing how many things are made from corn? And you know what we have? In the van, we have popsicles for you. Nice cold popsicles, and even they're made using corn syrup to make them sweet. So why don't we go on, let's put these all back in the box, and we'll go have some corn. We'll go eat those popsicles, and you can just think that you're eating corn. Let's go.